The Browns have hired Kevin Stefanski to be their new head coach. If you don't know, Kevin Stefanski was formerly just his most recent job was with the Minnesota Vikings as the Vikings offensive coordinator. And some people are immediately criticized the Cleveland Browns for hiring Kevin Stefanski because with Kevin Stefanski's last game as the Minnesota Vikings offensive coordinator, the team only put up 10 points against the 49ers defense. And I think that I get why Cleveland Browns fans are really skeptical. I get it. They're very disappointed. It's been a long, if you're a Browns fan, you've had a long, brutal history as a Browns fan. But you got to understand that the Vikings loss to the 49ers, and in fact, even, I know he's a coordinator, but the Vikings' lack of points against the 49ers defense was not actually Kevin Stefanski's fault. Sometimes you can make great play calls and your team just gets physically dominated. That's exactly what happened. The 49ers defensive line took over that game. They kept winning one-on-one matchups. They kept destroying the Vikings offensive line. There's nothing you can do. You can't call better plays. If your guys just keep getting beat physically in one-on-one battles, it doesn't matter what plays you call. Kevin Stefanski is not the reason why the Vikings offense struggled against the San Francisco 49ers defense. It's because the 49ers defense is phenomenal. They're incredibly gifted. They destroyed the Vikings up front, and that's not Kevin Stefanski's fault. That's not the fault of scheme. That's not the fault of this or that. That's sometimes you just can't coach that. It's, hey, our guys are better than your guys. I don't know. I think some guys don't understand. That was just scheme. That wasn't scheme. That was guys just getting beat. I wanted to defend Kevin Stefanski. He did a really good job all year for the Minnesota Vikings. Kevin Stefanski is a really good offensive coordinator. He does a great job creating good matchups for his players. He puts his players in a really good position to be successful. I don't know whether or not Stefanski is going to succeed with the Cleveland Browns, but that's more because I don't trust the Cleveland Browns organization. It has nothing to do with Kevin Stefanski. Now, you got it. I don't know. I don't care who you are. I'm not a Browns fan. I really like the Browns because they're just like the little engine that could. It's this guy that you just want the Browns to succeed. Like, for the love of God, please. They've been so bad for so many years. I just want to see Cleveland turn things around. But I don't care who you are. You have to acknowledge Kevin Stefanski is a massive upgrade over the former Browns head coach, Freddie Kitchens. No offense to Freddie Kitchens. The guy had no idea what he was doing. He couldn't even call an offense, let alone run a football team. At the very least, Kevin Stefanski understands what he's doing. With the keys to the car running an offense, he's going to call plays that are designed to help Baker Mayfield to set up our Odell Beckham Jr., Jarvis Landry, David Njoku. He's going to use the weapons that the Cleveland Browns have to benefit their team and maybe help them get wins. Already, Kevin Stefanski is a gigantic upgrade over Freddie Kitchens, the former head coach. Now, it's really hard to know whether or not Kevin Stefanski will ultimately be successful as the Cleveland Browns head coach. He's never been a head coach before, and this is me being honest. I have no idea. I hope he's successful. I really don't know. But I gotta say, I hope it works. I really, really, I'm not from Ohio. I don't really care about the Cleveland Browns. I just know that, man, they've been so bad for so many, my entire lifetime, they've had like one good season ever. I would love to see the Cleveland Browns have a resurgence, maybe have a winning record, maybe have some success for the poor people of Cleveland. I just feel bad for them. And even more than all of that, I really, really, really hate missed opportunities. Nothing drives me crazier and more angry than when I see something that could be great and the potential isn't met. And that's exactly what Cleveland is. They have so many offensive weapons. They have a really young, talented quarterback. They have talented receivers. They have talent all over the place on the roster. If they can't figure out how to win, it's just one of the world's biggest disappointments and the world's biggest missed opportunities. If the ownership can't get out of the way and if the Browns cannot find a way to win, I'm not a Browns fan. I shouldn't really care, but I do because I want to see them do it. And it's my like level of OCD where I just hate when people miss opportunities. And the Browns, if they can't find a way to win in Cleveland, it's one of the biggest missed opportunities in sports in a long, long time. Now, I watched Kevin Stefanski's introductory press conference with the Cleveland Browns I got to say, number one is that the Browns owner, Jimmy Haslam, I don't know how to say that. I really want to be, I don't want to be super harsh. I want to be respectful. It was weird that he had, there was a moment where he's introducing Kevin Stefanski, the new head coach of the Cleveland Browns. And it's like he literally mentions that he doesn't even know the names of everybody in his family. He had to like look at his notes. And I get it. That's honest. I don't want to be too harsh here. Like as a broadcaster myself, if there's a name I don't know, I just go to the notes and say, look, I'll be honest. I don't know what I'm saying, so I'm going to read it. But it was weird because the contrast between Jimmy Haslam hiring Kevin Stefanski and David Tepper hiring Matt Rhule to be the Carolina Panthers head coach. You know, David Tepper's the Panthers owner. When David Tepper talked about, you know, Matt Rhule, the new Panthers head coach, it's clear they knew each other really well. They talked about each other like they were already family. And David Tepper talked about his, you know, Matt Rhule's family with such fondness. And he liked the kids and the wife and this and that. And the weird disconnect with Jimmy Haslam and Kevin Stefanski's family was just, it was a weird start to the press conference. I know I'm nitpicking to a massive degree, but the contrast in other owners talking about their new head coach and Jimmy Haslam, the Browns owner, talking about his new head coach, there was just a level of weird uncomfortableness where it's like, do you know the names of everybody in his family? Do you know the family of the guy you hired? It was weird and uncomfortable. I've talked about that part way too long. I gotta say, I absolutely loved everything Kevin Stefanski had to say in his introductory press conference. In fact, I think actually what I liked more than that was I loved everything that he didn't say. He didn't overpromise. He didn't make bold statements. Kevin Stefanski was very, it was cool. He wasn't trying to sell himself. He wasn't trying to win the press conference. He was just like, here I am. I am myself. I'm going to get through this. It was pretty clear Kevin Stefanski doesn't care what the media thinks of him, like to some degree where I think Kevin Stefanski, I don't know how to put that properly. I think what I mean to say is that I think Kevin Stefanski wants to prove his worth as a head coach on the field rather than in a press conference. He knows that my entire lifetime, coaches have come and gone from Cleveland, and they've had this introductory press conference countless times in Cleveland's past, and coaches come in, and they're all rah-rah. They say this and that. We're going to do this lofty goal and this lofty goal. We're going to change things. We're going to turn things around, and Kevin Stefanski didn't do that. He was very measured. He was very even keel. He wouldn't even commit to whether or not he's going to call plays this fall. Like, I really liked it because he wasn't, again, trying to sell himself. He wasn't trying to win the press conference. And he was trying to keep expectations tempered. And I like that. It's rare to see that, especially from a new head coach. Stefanski said almost nothing. And that's kind of a skill to be able to talk for 30 minutes and say basically nothing in 30 minutes. It's exactly what you want from a head coach. You know, we saw Bill O'Brien, the head coach of the Houston Texans the other day, totally put his foot in his mouth. It's like giving away far too much information in a press conference. Like, why would you admit that? I think Kevin Stefanski is going to be genius in press conferences because he can talk for 30 minutes and say absolutely nothing. Now, we did seem just eager to work. I like the way he talked about Baker Mayfield. He sees a lot of potential. I got to say, man, if I am, as an offensive coach, if I was an offensive coach taking over the helm of the Cleveland Browns, I'd be really excited to get to work with the talented roster they have, to work with Baker Mayfield, to work with Odell Beckham Jr., Jarvis Landry, Nick Chubb, David Njoku. I mean, there is so much talent just waiting to be used properly in Cleveland. It'd be awesome, man. I really like it. And I love the way that Kevin Stefanski answered questions. He didn't allow the media to corner him. He was very composed. We really have no idea what he's going to do, but it really rubbed me the right way. It meant a lot to me that Kevin Stefanski didn't overpromise. He didn't say, I'm going to do this and this and this. He just was like, I'm going to come in. We have good people here in the building. People matter. And I'm going to make changes and we're going to do good. That's all he said, and it was enough. Now, I am skeptical because it's the Cleveland Browns. I have no idea whether or not Kevin Stefanski can do it. He's never done the job before. But I am hopeful for the Cleveland Browns because they got a ton of talent. They have a ton of talent in that building. And if they can't find a way with an offensive coach to at the very least score a lot of points in Cleveland, there is just massive problems with the Cleveland Browns. And maybe they're so bad they can't even find a way to score points with elite receivers, elite running back, probably an elite quarterback, an elite tight end. If they can't find a way to score points with Kevin Stefanski as a head coach, everything's wrong in Cleveland, and I don't even know where to begin. Now, I will add one final kind of odd thing. The Browns didn't hire Josh McDaniels, who is the New England Patriots offensive coordinator. And the reason that was reported was because Josh McDaniels apparently wanted to make sweeping changes throughout the Browns organization, especially the front office. And it's concerning that the Browns ownership, and especially Jimmy Haslam, didn't want to make changes. They said that the reason why they didn't hire Josh McDaniels was because of the changes that Jimmy Haslam, that he wanted to make. And so it's interesting to me. Jimmy Haslam, the owner of the Cleveland Browns, has a bunch of people in his ear. Paul DePodesta, other names I can't remember right now. But he has a bunch of guys in his ear giving him feedback constantly about the football team. And Josh McDaniels, if he was hired by the Browns, Josh McDaniels wanted those guys out. He said, I don't want you to have a side jury giving you constant alternate information. I want to have a one-to-one relationship with you. And obviously the people that Josh McDaniels wanted to fire didn't like that. But ultimately, Jimmy Haslam decided not to do that. And I want to be very honest about that. How have those people, the people that Josh McDaniels wanted to get rid of, the people in the ownership's ear, in the front office, kind of working as consultants, doing who knows what the heck they're doing, how much have they really helped the Cleveland Browns in recent years? Because if you look back at recent years, the Browns have been awful for a long, long time. And I don't understand why the Browns have this intense loyalty to the front office guys they already have there. It hasn't worked. They haven't succeeded in a long, long time, in years. I mean, the Browns are the only team in the last decade to not have a winning season in the last 10 years. Between 2010 and 2020, they haven't had a winning season yet. That's unbelievable. That's ridiculous. It's so weird to me. The franchise is in an awful state, and yet still, for some reason, the Browns have no desire to change their front office and no desire to take a different approach with ownership. Look, I think Kevin Stefanski might be the right guy. I have no reason not to believe in him. He seems like a safe hire. Seems like he's good enough. But will the Browns' lack of willingness to make changes in the front office, will that come back to haunt them later? I have no idea, but it's a storyline worth following and worth mentioning. Maybe the Browns' desire to not make changes in the front office, maybe that'll come back to haunt them and hurt them later down the road.